So what are the paintings based off, the guitars?
Yeah, all these images come from the instruments. And several of them in the show from Rosewood. Also, this is Rosewood.
Wow.
Where are you going to put these?
Huh?
Where are these going?
They're staying right here.
Oh, okay. But do you have an exhibition lined up?
For these?
Yeah.
Not yet.
Okay.
The show at the museum was, the installation there was the first of its kind, but I didn't only discovered recently that these images grew out of my passion for the instruments.
I got it, for sure.
And it wasn't, I had work hanging on the wall, and I brought a couple of instruments in because somebody was coming over to play, and I leaned them against the wall and realized that that's where all these images came from. The shapes of the guitar.
Do you play? What do you play?
I used to play, but I've got a condition called neuropathy, and my fingers don't work very good. But I'm doing some physical therapy and other kinds of stuff. The only way you really cure yourself of that is the surgery in your neck, and I was going to do that a few weeks ago when I was in L.A. and I chickened out at the last moment. You just want to show off, don't you?
What's your dog's name?
Huh? Pinky.
Pinky.
Pinky, you're good looking.
And does Pinky only stay in towels?
Huh?
Does Pinky only stay here?
She always stays with me, wherever I am, unless I have to get on an airplane. I drive to L.A. and I take her with me. I have a studio there in Venice. I spent about 3 weeks here and about 3 weeks there. 1915.
Which one?
This one. It's called the Galliano by a guy named Oscar Schmidt. There's another one of these in the show at the museum. Like I said, it's out of tune.
Do you do ukulele?
I don't have a ukulele. That's, well, I do, actually.
Is that one?
No, that's something called a tipple.
Do you have an all-time favorite?
It's in the show.
Okay, and what is it?
It's made by the same guy who made that little one in the corner, that little guy, and the huge one between the red and black pieces. His name is Fred Gerlach, and he lived in Venice.
Fred Gerlach.
Yeah.
Do you like Gibson guitars?
What?
Gibson?
Gibson, those are all Gibson.
Oh, okay, wow.
Another couple of buildings that different operations basically.
How long have you lived in Taos?
73.
Where were you raised?
LA.
LA.
I was born in Chicago, but my parents moved there to LA in 1945, actually, the day the war, second war ended. Dad pulled a trailer with a 40 Plymouth out across Route 66. I have some vague memories of that. These are the pumps that take the air out of that one. And these are the pumps that take the air out of the big tank.
That is absolutely incredible. Wow. Did this building have to be built around this equipment?
I know. There's a big door that's sealed in that back wall underneath the window there. We dragged it in there. But we did, actually the building was a ruin, but we had put a roof on it, and we had to get it, the equipment inside something that wasn't going to ruin it from the weather. And so in a sense we did build the building around it. This is the driver's seat when I'm working. I watch what's happening in the tank through this window.
And while you're doing this, you're wearing like protection? What? Are you wearing like something?
No,
no?
There's no gas. There's no, or anything that
escapes.
That are out here. No,
I see.
No, no.
Wow.
That's a half inch thick stainless steel.
Wow. Wow.
So what's being made in there?
What
do you make inside here?
I make a vacuum inside. I pump the air out of it. So we need to work at very low pressures, or else when you heat up the stuff, if there's any air in there, that it'll burn, it'll decompose.
I see.
So you have to get all the air out that would cause the material to decompose. And so.
And what year did you hire the Edwards to make this?
1968. It came in 69. So smaller.
What are these?
Those are tests for that center panel came off of a cube that it was damaged, and so the collector asked me to try and remake that panel so that it matched the rest of them. And we are now experimenting in how I did that one. I couldn't remember. So we've got parts in the tank now of this just window glass, so that we're trying different things to get to the same coloring and the same configuration on the surface.
Can I have the reject?
Huh?
Can I have the reject?
No. So these things are part of the evidence of the development of the replacement for this. It's all part of the history of the studio activities.
Yeah.
You won't see any streaks on the glass, hopefully, or watermarks or anything, mm-hmm. as we go through a whole... That's the hardest part of the whole process, is cleaning the surfaces. We close this room and filter the air, and these are electrostatic cleaners for the air, put a positive pressure in here so that when we go in and out of the room, the air goes out instead of dust coming in. Yeah. What? Oh, you want a treat, don't you? Well, they're next door. You'll have to wait till I get back. Just wait. This is a fixture that holds these pieces of glass. There's another one just like it in the tank, and glass sits on this thing. We put two pieces of glass in, and this will turn when we need it. So because there's two different kinds of materials being evaporated from both sides of the tank.
Does he have one of yours?
Yeah, we swapped.
Wow. How old is that?
It is new. It's a new piece. I don't know. You know, from last year maybe, something like that. It's the studio that he makes these things in is in Hungary.
Right.
In